Talbiya.
You remember talbiya. You remember that God is there. You are watching God. And you are telling yourself, I am always there at your disposal, O God. My services, my body, my wealth, my capabilities, my life, my everything is for you, God. You are there. That's the message behind that.
Very good, Professor Sir. Atik bhai, this ritual also of Qurbani, generally we see that Muslims, they do Qurbani, sacrifice of an animal. Could you just put some light on this ritual of Qurbani?
Yeah, certainly. Before answering your question, just would like to add what Professor Saab said about the spirit of Ihram. He spoke about being a servant, a beggar. Apart from that, one very strong message which Ihram, that two clothes gives, is that when life ends, every individual have to go from this world with just two pieces of cloth. Whether he is a lord or whether he is a king, a celebrity or a businessman, he will not carry anything from this world except those two cloths. That's one strong message of Ihram. Coming to the question of sacrifice, as I said, this whole worship of Hajj is a reenactment of the life of Prophet Ibrahim. This sacrifice is in remembrance of his act of being ready to sacrifice his son on the order of God Almighty, the only son which God gave him at the age of 86 years. Imagine a situation, somebody getting a son at 86 years old, God orders him to sacrifice, to slaughter him, and he is ready to please God, please Allah. But God gets pleased, and he sends a sheep from the heaven, and there that sheep gets slaughtered. So in remembrance to that act of Ibrahim, Prophet Ibrahim, peace be upon him, the Muslims do this act of sacrifice. One, people who physically and go to the Hajj, they perform all the rituals, as Professor Saab said. But people who do not go to Hajj, they do that act of sacrificing an animal, and they join in those celebrations of Hajj as well. One thing, it's just not about sacrificing an animal, a sheep or a goat. It is also about sacrificing your comfort, your worldly pleasures and desires, sacrificing your wealth, your time. Because with all the sacrifices, you go to pilgrimage. You leave everything behind you, your friends, your relatives, the way Prophet Ibrahim left his family, his land, his relatives. He left his child and wife. Similar way, we all leave our relatives, the worldly pleasures, the businesses, the bank balance and everything, and in simple attire, prove that we are all humble and humble in front of the Almighty God. So the sacrifice is about remembering that act of Prophet Ibrahim.
Very good, Atik bhai.
It's a noble cause.
It's a noble cause. Okay. Maulana sahab, Hajj ko log jo hai, jaisa aapne bataya ki log jo hai, apni zindagi mein ek baar jo hai, Hajj ko jana chahiye. हज के पहले मैं हूँ और हज को जाके आने के बाद में मेरे में क्या तब्दीली, क्या चेंजेस आना चाहिए?
जी जी, बड़ा अच्छा सवाल है. देखिए, हज के अंदर एक हाजी की पूरी ज़िंदगी बिल्कुल तब्दील हो जाती है, कि इनकलाब बरपा हो जाता है. अब तक वो हज से पहले एक आज़ाद इंसान था, वो अब अल्लाह ताला का बंदा बन जाता है, अल्लाह का मुखलिस बंदा बन जाता है. उसकी ज़िंदगी बिल्कुल गुनाहों से पाक व साफ हो जाती है. खुद अल्लाह के रसूल सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम ने फरमाया कि जब हाजी हज के दौरान कोई गलत काम ना करे, अल्लाह की नाफरमानी ना करे, फहश काम ना करे, झगड़ा ना करे, तो वह इस तरह वापस लौटता है जैसा कि अभी अभी उसकी माँ ने उसको जन्म दिया है. तो हाजी के अंदर एक साल इनकलाब बरपा होना चाहिए. लोग देखें तो महसूस हो कि ये है मुसलमान, बल्कि दूसरे लोग उसको इशारे से कहें कि मुसलमान ऐसा होता है जो किसी को धोखा नहीं देता, जो कभी गलत काम नहीं करता, जो दूसरों की बुराई नहीं चाहता, बल्कि अल्लाह और अल्लाह के रसूल सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम की हिदायत के मुताबिक ज़िंदगी गुजारता है. वो एक नमूना बनता है, ख़ुद अल्लाह से मोहब्बत करने वाला होता है, बंदों से मोहब्बत करने वाला होता है, उसकी पूरी ज़िंदगी हमदर्दी की ज़िंदगी होती है, बल्कि ऐसा इनकलाब कि गोया उसकी ज़िंदगी बिल्कुल ही तब्दील हो गई हो. गुनाहों से जिस तरह पाक हुआ है उसी तरह साले इंकलाब उसकी ज़िंदगी में बरपा हो गई,
मतलब उसकी पर्सनैलिटी में जो है चेंजेस आना चाहिए,
बिल्कुल आना चाहिए। अगर नहीं आता है तो फिर ये समझ लीजिए कि अल्लाह ताला ने उसके हज को कबूल नहीं किया, या ये कि वहाँ जाकर वो वापस आया वहाँ से कुछ फ़ायदा नहीं उठाया, अगर उसकी ज़िंदगी में इंकलाब ना आए।
शुक्रिया मौलाना साहब। ये प्रोफेसर साहब आपसे एक सवाल, आखिरी सवाल होगा, ये पूरा जो जर्नी है हज का, इससे क्या लेसन्स हम लोग लेना चाहिए, और साथ ही साथ जैसा अभी आपने बड़ी अच्छे अंदाज में बताया कि प्रॉफिट इब्राहिम के बारे में आपने बताया, यू हैव टोल्ड अस सो मेनी थिंग्स विच आर कॉमन बिटवीन वेरियस रिलीजन्स अबाउट प्रॉफिट इब्राहिम, कुड यू टेल अस एग्जैक्टली यू नो हाउ इन द लाइट ऑफ दिस हज इट शुड हेल्प अस टू बी अ बेटर पर्सन?
यस, यू सी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड से is a message of Hajj is unity of mankind.
Unity of mankind.
Yes. You go there and you see people from all the countries are there. The blacks are there, the whites are there, the Chinese are there, Japanese are there. From India, from Sri Lanka, from Bangladesh, from Pakistan, from Arab, from all the countries. So you'll find all tribes, all people, all races there. So what do you find? All human beings are there, but they are performing together as one race. So they become united. So one message is that all of you are one, differences apart. It reminds you of the Quranic verse in Surah Al-Hujurat. Is Quran says, Inna khalaqnakum min zakarin wa unsa وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا إِنَّا أَكْرَمَكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهِ يَتْقَاكُمْ. So this exactly is the myth. What is this? We created you, O mankind, we created you from one man and one woman. So all the people, Hindus or Muslims or Christians or Sikhs or Jews or any people, all these are created from one man and one couple. Your parents are same, common parents. You are children of same parents. That is one. Unity of mankind. Because you believe in one God. Everybody believes in one God. So that is number one, unity. And number two, you see, Hajj is essentially, as you just asked 5 minutes back, a question to him about sacrifice. You see, Hajj reminds you of sacrifice. It is sheer sacrifice, nothing else. Now, what is the meaning of sacrifice? Qurbani, as you said. Sacrifice is, you know, a person, you know, he disowns his claim, his sense of affinity, that it is mine. He will not claim it. It is mine. He will, you know, disown it in favor of others. He will sacrifice whatever he has, his possessions, his wealth, or in any terms, it may be in any aspect, a person, you know, renounces himself, he relinquishes his claim in favor of others. He thinks of others better. And in Quran it is said, مَنْ يُوقَ شُحَى نَفْسِهِ, means the one who has been rescued from narrow-mindedness succeeded in life. The message of Hajj is Qurbani, sacrifice. So we are willing to sacrifice for a noble cause, for a greater cause, not for selfishness, not for any ulterior motive, for a greater cause, for a noble cause, anything. Even I can sacrifice my life for truth and truth alone. So here they will not fight for mine and thine, Hindus or Muslims or Christians or caste and language or region or race and all that. Man rises above all these and prepares to sacrifice himself for all these people. You see, they are mine, they are my brethren. This is the message of Hajj that we get.
Shukriya, Professor Saab. Thank you very much. Brother Atik, last before we wind up this special program today, what would be the message you would want to give our viewers today?
Well, with the discussion we have had so far, so we get to know a lot of things which the friends from the society can take, and we all, as a, you know, concerned citizen of this country, should be taking. One, it is connected to the life of Prophet Ibrahim, peace be upon him. So the qualities of Prophet Ibrahim, peace be upon him, of submission, obedience and sacrifice are to be derived in our lives so that we eradicate the evils of the society. Second, we spoke about Hajj, the rituals, the spirit behind it. So with the same spirit of unity of mankind, irrespective of caste, creed, nationality, color, language, we all need to unite to eradicate the problems of the humanity across the globe, not just India, not just Goa, but across the world. That is the second message which we all need to take. Thirdly, as one, you know, one fraternity of the first parents, being the generation of one parents, Project. We all need to unite to fight casteism, regionalism, racism, which is a bigger issue, and fascism in today's present context. So I believe and I hope that we all will unite together on this occasion of Eid al-Adha, which is the festival of sacrifice, in eradicating these isms, these evil things which are spoiling this beautiful earth of God. So as creatures of one God, we all need to unite to make this world a peaceful place for communal harmony, brotherhood, love and coexistence.
And a better place to live.
And a better place, definitely.
Definitely, yes.
To live.
Professor Saab, last few words for our viewers, what would it be?
Yes, I would say, you know, we are living in 21st century. And this century is in the era of globalization. All of us will have to rise above our communal, sectarian and all other narrow approaches to others. We should be more objective, more rationalistic, more tolerant and respecting each other. And above all, what is important is, why not all of us become the seekers of truth? Our commitment to truth should be absolute and uncompromising. And the last but not the least, let us know our God. The same God belongs to all of us. Let us try to know our God. That should be the message from this festival of Eid, Eid al-Adha. Thank you very much.
Shukriya Maulana Sahab, Atiq Bhai, Professor Sahab, thank you very much for coming here, educating us on this show. And to all our viewers, thank you very much for watching this. Do let us know, send us your feedback, send us your comments. We appreciate any all reviews from you. Keep watching Prudent Media. Thank you.